Okay, I'm hoping this will be the final video because we've had to let it dry. This will be the final application because I think as thin as I'm going to use the iridescent paint, the quick it's going to dry real quick, and then I can go over it with Mod Podge. But I think the first thing I'm going to do right now before I forget is sign it. I usually sign my work here at the bottom somewhere. So I'll put in my little Y M 2020. You can see that 2020. That's where I signed it, right there. Now, as I'm taping, I see the reflection as backwards. And I know on my last tape I said, this looks backwards to you. Well, when you play the video, it reads right. So you'll be able to read it the right way. I didn't know as I played back the video. I said, oh, they can read it. It does read right. Okay, so this is totally dry. And what I use is this Crystal Sparkles. And it's glitter puff paint, but it's kind of clear. And it's just got crystal sparkles. And it's really funny because I think it's kind of got a glowy iridescent look about it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the starfish first, and I'll show you how it. You just put some on there, just a little bit, like that. Then you take your brush and you just spread it out like paint. And a little bit goes a long way. So one little squirt. And you can see the iridescent blue. I think you can see it pretty much. You can see the iridescent blue on there. It's different than what you see over here. So that's how it looks. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some in this little tray, and I'll be dipping into it with my brush because I want to be able to do it all, you know, all at once, not squirt by squirt. So I'm just going to spread it on there, on her tail, and you can just cover the whole thing. You don't have to go by sections. You can just cover the whole thing. It's really cool. It dries very iridescent and sparkly. We love sparkle, don't we? You want to stay in the boundary because you don't want the water to, because it'll show and it'll look like a mistake. Which it is, but I'm just saying that we want to keep this within the So I use puff paint multi-use. I have multi-use for puff paint. I don't just use it to, you know, create lines and stuff. I do other things with it, you know, like I'm doing right now. And it protects the ink also. So if you can see, you can see the glitter. It's teeny tiny glitter. And it's got a little like blue fluorescent hue to it. If you could see that. I don't know if you can see the blue hue. But it really, it shows up great. It shows up great. So there it is. There's her tail all done. And I might go ahead and just do a little bit on her hair. What do you think? Just a little bit. Just to give her that iridescent. Oh yeah, she looks good. So I will be putting this up for sale, ladies. And of course, you are more than welcome to try and do this yourself, following my videos. And that would be exciting. I would love to see you try it and see how it turns out. You can use any kind of wood that you want to use. You don't have to use what I'm using. You can use 2x4 or anything you want to use. But I've done her hair now. Yep, there she is. You get it out of the line, just lick your finger and wipe it off. And in a minute or two, which I think it'll be dry, because it doesn't take long at all for this to dry. It's very, very, I mean, it's quick. It dries really quick. So I'll Mod Podge it and I'll show you how to do that. But it's real simple. I mean, you just get a bigger brush and you just cover the whole thing and it dries like that. So it's really, really doable in one video. I don't want to make another one. So I'll clean my brush, make sure all that puff paint's out of it. So I think she turned out pretty good. And she will be for sale for $18 on our Bling on the Crafts webpage on Facebook. And she will be $18. And I'll add a hanger on the back and my label. Look at that, it's almost dry. Almost dry, people, almost dry. And then I'll do the Mod Podge. It'll seal the whole thing to where nothing will disturb it, you know. So it doesn't take just a minute or two for it to dry. See, this is already dry. That's dry. So we're ready for Mod Podge. And the reason you want it dry is because you're going to cover the whole thing. And you don't want the sparkles to go onto the water, because we want to keep them separate, you know, as standing out, as separate pieces of art. Because if you do it too soon and the sparkles get in the water, then, I don't know, do you think it would be muddy? I don't know. I don't know. Would I want sparkles in the water or not? I guess it wouldn't hurt to have a few, but, yeah, I guess that would be, because you could, if you wanted to put sparkles in the water and just leave her body without sparkles, that would stand out. So there's several ways you could do it. I mean, it's just whatever you prefer, you know? So I'll get my bigger brush out. I think this is my 1-inch brush or 3/4 inch or something like that. And I'll wet it. Make sure it's all separated. Okay. And what I'm going to do, sometimes I do this and then I do that, but I think I'm going to pour it in a container because I want to be able to control where this is going. So I'm going to do this half first. I'm going to go over the star and the label. And I don't see any sparkles spreading. So I think the star is dry. Okay. And you just spread it on there. I'm going to do this half first. Just clear sealer. That's what it is. Mod Podge is just clear sealer. You seal your artwork with it. And nothing can hurt it. And you can see the iridescent of the Mod Podge compared to the rest of the board. See, it's dull by her tail, and then it's shiny. Shiny on her arm, see? And believe it or not, Mod Podge dries real quick, so you have to be fast. You have to be fast because... And I'm going to have to get some more Mod Podge because I did not pour enough in there. At least now I know I need a full cup of it for a whole board. Here we go. And no, the translucent sparkles did not spread onto the water, which is good. But I could always go back and add it if I wanted to, because just re-Mod Podge it, you know? And there she is. She is all done. She is all done, people. And clean your brush on the edge and reapply. You can do that too. But we are done. We are done with her. She's done. So this is only... Yeah, there she is. Totally finished. Mod Podged. See the translucent glitter? There she is. It's a little white, silver and white mermaid in the ocean. I hope you like it, and I hope this was helpful for you. And I will see you Tuesday night on Bling on the Crafts. Bye.